Foxes are incredibly cute. Their pointy little ears and button nose makes them look adorable, while their fluffy fur coat looks perfect for snuggling. In the 1950s, Russian geneticist Dmitry K. Belyaev and his colleagues actually tried to tame the fox to study how those animals are domesticated. They chose silver foxes that didn't show much aggression to human touch. Over the course of 50 years, they only kept foxes that behaved in a tame manner and allowed them to breed. This created the first ever pet fox. However, before this decades-long experiment, there are no records of pet foxes in human history. We domesticated the wolf, giving rise to man's best friend, but why didn't early humans domesticate foxes? It's odd to think that humans haven't domesticated foxes when we consider that wolves, the ancestors of dogs, are part of the same family, Canidae. Our modern pet dogs are the result of thousands of years of selective breeding, a practice where only certain animals with desirable traits are allowed to breed. While we don't know exactly how humans tamed wild wolves, it is suggested that Stone Age humans picked wolves that were simply more friendly towards humans. Over tens of thousands of years of selective breeding, we've reached the stage of labradoodles and greyhounds, so why not foxes? One reason is that foxes might simply be too wild. A lot of anecdotal evidence refers to foxes as either too shy or chaotic. The Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, RSPCA, stated that because foxes are wild animals, they do not fare well as domestic pets. Their often wild and rambunctious behavior might be the reason that foxes never made it as our companions. Foxes are also solitary animals who hunt and rear their young only with their mates. Wolves, on the other hand, frequently hunt in packs. The presence of a social structure might have made wolves more open to humans and better company for hunter-gatherers. The Russian fox farm experiment showed that it is possible to tame foxes. They noticed that with every generation, the foxes grew tamer and actually began looking and behaving more like dogs. They became cuter and started wagging their tails, and surprisingly, they even developed dog-like abilities, such as responding to human emotions and learning tricks. However, this process was a difficult one. There is evidence that early humans did try to domesticate foxes, but this obviously didn't work. Wolves and wild cats were apparently more tameable than foxes, so early humans may have simply given up trying, leaving cats and dogs to readily step in as companions for early humans. Foxes that live near cities and come in regular contact with humans are known to be more open to interaction. They take food directly from humans and aren't afraid of our presence. However, this openness doesn't necessarily mean that they are tame. With all this evidence, scientists are now looking into which genes are responsible for making the fox so inherently untamable. The research on fox domestication also has the potential to help us understand how traits like loyalty, tameness, and intelligence are encoded in our own brain and genes. It could even reveal how Stone Age humans may have domesticated other animals and provide additional insight to their ancient lifestyles. The fox taming experiment that started almost 70 years ago has faced many challenges. This work has provided us with a deeper understanding of the animals around us and the very long history that we share. If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more animated stories on the science in our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.